Hi everyone, in this video we will discuss all the type B questions from chapter 9 of class 12, that is data structure first part, linear list. The first question is like this: create a list SQLST that stores doubles of elements of another list numlst. Will the code work as desired? What will be stored in SQLST? So this is the question. Here you can see there is a list numlst having values 2, 5, 1, 7, 3, 6, 8, 9 like this. And SQLST is assigned with a value numlst into 2. Now let's see what it is storing. You can see the output is like this. Whatever is the value or data is there in numlst, that is just printed twice. So this code will not produce the desired output. Here, the length of the list gets doubled by storing the elements of numlist 2 times in the list SQLST. Why? Because we assign numlst into 2. That means whatever is there in numlst, that will be doubled. That means this, it will be printed 2 times consecutively. So you can see the content of SQLST. Now change the above code so that it works as stated in previous question. Now we will change the code like this. NumLST is a list. Now SQLST will be n into 2 for n in numlist. So this is basically one list comprehension we did over here. So whatever is the value present in numlist, the each item will be collected and that will be multiplied by 2 and stored in a new list SQLST. Now once we print this SQLST, you can see the output like this. It's storing 4, 10, 2, 14 like this, which are the double of each of the elements of list numlst. Now modify the previous code so that SQLST stores the doubled numbers in ascending order. Now let's see how to do this. It's the same thing, numlst is there. Now SQLST will be n into 2 for n in numlist. That is, it will print the double of the elements present in numlist, but it has to be stored in sorted order. So we have simply used the sorted function over here. So we have written like this, sorted, and within parentheses we passed the list comprehension statement. Now it will store the sorted values of the doubled values. Output is like this, 2, 4, 6, 10, 12, like this. Now consider the list ML, which is having value 1, 4, 9, 16, 25, like this. Now write a code using list comprehension to store only even numbers from ML to a new list. So this is a very simple list comprehension statement, just you have to write. ML is defined over here. Now there is another list, let's say even LST. So it is storing the value like this, n for n in ML if n is divisible by 2. So whatever values that is present in ML, if that is even number, then that will be stored in the list even LST. Now we'll print even LST to see the output. You can see the output is like this. Now the next question is to write equivalent list comprehension for this code. So there's a code like this. There's a list target 1 which is empty. Now for number in source, if number and 1 colon target 1 dot append that number. That means there is a list called source having some values. Let's say I have initialized with some values 2, 3, 5, 7, 9, 1, 2 like this. Now there is another list called target 1. Then what it will store? It will check all the values, all the elements from the list source. And if you do AND operation with that element with 1 and it is producing true result, then that will be stored in this list target 1. So you can see this. So the source list contains some even and odd numbers. As you can see here, some numbers when they are ANDed, that means you are doing AND operation with 1, that is bitwise operation, then some numbers will produce true value and some numbers will produce false. So whatever numbers are producing true value, those are stored in a list target 1. So the output of target 1 is like this. Now the next question is to write equivalent for loop for the following list comprehension. You can see the list comprehension is like this. Gen is equal to I by 2 for I in 0, 9, 21, 32. Now print gen. Now let's see. There is a list called LST having values 0, 9, 21, and 32. And gen is one empty list. Now the for loop goes like this. For I in LST, gen dot append I by 2. Now print gen. Now you can see. Now gen will contain all the values from the list LST which are divided by 2. That means 0 divided by 2, that is 0.0. Second, 9 divided by 2, that is 4.5. 21 by 2, 10.5. Like this, this is the content of the list gen. Now predict the output of following code if input is, first set of input is 12, 3, 4, 5, 7, 12, 8, 23, and 12. And there is another set of input. Now we'll see the first one. There is a variable called s, that is eval input enter a list. That means you have to enter a list while running the program, and the content of the items of the list are given in the question. 12, 3, 4, 5, like this. Now n is equal to length of s. So now t is equal to, there is a list slicing down over here, t is equal to s of 1 colon n minus 1. So t is the list slice having elements with index number 1 to index number n minus 1. That means t will store all the elements from list s excluding the first element and last element. Now you have to print s of 0 is equal to s of n minus 1. So there is a comparison done over here. S of 0 is, if you take the first set of values, s of 0 is 12 and s of n minus 1 is also 12. So first condition will give you true value. Now second one, and t dot count s of 0 equal to 0. So it is counting how many times s of 0 is present in the list t. S of 0 is, as you know, it is 12, but t is the elements which are excluding the first 12 and last 12, that is starting from 3 to 23. So it will check whether in the list 12 is there or not. If it is there, then how many times it is there. So here count of s of 0, that is 12, is equal to 1, because there is one more 12 present in the list. The second condition will not give you true result. Second condition will give you false. So overall the output will be false. So if you run the program, it will ask you to enter a list, and we have entered a list as per the list given in the question, that is 12, 3, 4, 5, 7, 12, 8, 23, and 12. And the output will be false, as I told right now. Among the two conditions, first one is true, as s of 0 is same as s of n minus 1, that is 12. But the second one is false, as t dot count of 12 is equal to 1, which is not 0. So the overall result is false. All right. Now we'll execute the same code, but this time we will give a different list. Now this time if you run, the list entered is like this: 8, 9, 2, 3, 7, and 8. So here the sliced list, that is t will store all the values excluding the first value and the last value. That means t will contain 9, 2, 3, and 7. Now in the print statement, you can see there are two conditions. First one is s of 0 is equal to s of n minus 1. The first one is true, because s of 0 is same as s of n minus 1. And the second one is also true, as t dot count of 8 is equal to 0. That means within t, inside the list t, count of 8 is 0. That means 8 item is not present in the list t. So in both the cases, both the conditions are true, and these two conditions are and over here, anded over here, and the output is, overall result is true. Now the next question is to predict the output of the code. You can see, first of all, there is a function h underscore t, which is defined over here, which is taking an LST, which is basically a list variable. Now the function is defined like this. There is a variable called from back, which is storing an LST.pop. That means the last element from the list will be removed and will be stored in a variable from underscore back. And from underscore front is a variable which is storing an LST.pop of 0. That means the first element of the list will be popped and it will be stored in a variable from underscore front. Now, with the help of append method, the from front variable is appended with the list, and one more insert method is also called. Here, it is entering the value which is present in from back at the 0 position. Now, here you can see there is a list called NLST1 having value 2112, which is another sublist, and another element is 31. Now, NLST3 is equal to NLST1.copy. So, this copy method is used to copy one list into another list. So, here what will happen, the content of list NLST1 will be copied to NLST3. So, list is copied by using copy function. So, here whatever changes made in one list won't be reflected in another list. That means if you make any change in first list NLST1, then it will not be reflected in NLST3. And another assignment we are doing here, NLST2 is equal to NLST1. Here the content of first list is copied into the second list. But this type of copy statement, the list, whatever changes made in the first list or one list, that will be reflected in another list. So if we'll do any changes in NLST2, that will be reflected in NLST1. And whatever changes we'll do in NLST1, that will be reflected in NLST2. Now what we are doing next is NLST2 of -1 is equal to 5. That means we are assigning a new element 5 at the index number -1. So whatever changes we are doing in second list, that will be reflected in NLST1 also. So the content of NLST1 as well as NLST2 is equal to like this 2112, 5. Now one more insert operation is done. That is 6 is inserted at index number 1 of NLST2. So whatever changes will be done in NLST2, that will be reflected in NLST1. So after this insert operation, your NLST1 is equal to 2112, 6, 5. 6 is inserted at index number 1. So the new list is like this. Now let's see the second part of the program. Now here the function h underscore t is called with the value NLST1. NLST1 is passed within this function. Now the value of NLST1 is equal to like this 2112, 6, and 5. So this is the current list NLST1. Now once this function is called, all the statements which are there in this function definition, that will be called one by one. The first function that is called, that is NLST.pop, first statement, this one. So what will happen? 5 will be popped from this list NLST1, and the list becomes like this 2112 and 6. Next statement, what happens? NLST.pop of 0. The first element will be popped. Now the list becomes only 6. The third statement like this, NLST.append from front. So whatever is there in from front, that will be appended. So from front is containing the sublist 2112. So that will be appended with the list, which is having only one element, 6. Now the list becomes 6, 21, 12. Now the next operation is insert operation, which is the last statement of the function. So here what will happen? The 0 position from back element will be inserted. So after inserting, from back is containing the pop value, that is 5. So 5 will be inserted at index number 0. The now the new list becomes like this 5 comma 6 comma 21 comma 12. Now if you print NLST 1 of 0 comma NLST 1 of minus 1 comma length of NLST 1. So now the 0 index number, the value is 5, and minus 1 index number, the value is 21 comma 12, and the length of list is 3. So that will be the output. You can see the output is like this. 5, 21, comma 12, and 3. Similarly, we are printing NLST 2 of 0, NLST 2 of minus 1, and length of NLST 2. That will be same as NLST 1. That means whatever changes we are doing in one list, list 1, that will be reflected in 2. Or whatever we are doing in 2, that will be reflected in 1. And in the third print statement, it is printing NLST 3 of 0, 3 of minus 1 and all. So here NLST 3 is whatever we have copied from NLST 1 of previous time. So it is not changed. So the content of NLST 3 will be as in the beginning. So it will print like this 21, 12, comma 31, and the length is. Now predict the output of the following code. Ages is a list which is containing some values. Print ages. Now another list, a list, which is storing x for x in ages if x in range 14 to 18. So this is a list comprehension code. It will store the ages between 14 to 18, where 18 will be excluded. So if you print a list, the output is like this. It is storing only the values 14, 15, and 17. Fine. The next question is to predict the output. You can see here there are two lists. L1 is equal to x to the power 2 for x in range 10 if x is divisible by 3. So it will store the values like 3, 6, 9, all those. And L2 is equal to L1. Here L1 and L2 both contain 0, 9, 36, and 81. That means the square of the numbers which are divisible by 3. Whatever changes we'll make in one list, that will be reflected in the other list as well. Now L1.append length of L1. So length of L1 is 4. So the value 4 will be appended with the list L1 as well as with the list L2. Now if you print L1 and L2, then you can see the list L1 and L2 are showing like this 0, 9, 36, 81, and 4. The same also L2. Now L2.remove length of L2 minus 1. So here length of L2 is 5. 5 minus 1 is 4. So element at index number 4 will be removed from both the lists. Now if you print L1, then it will show like this 4 is removed from the list. The new list is like this 0, 9, 36, and 81. Now the next question is to predict the output. Here there is a function defined even, which is taking one value as its argument, and it is returning n% 2 equal to 0. That means if it is divisible by 2, then it will return true, otherwise it will return false. Now there is a list called list1 having values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And EV is another list which will store n for n in list1 if n% 2 equal to 0. Now here EV will be a list which will store the even numbers from list1. Now EVP is another list which will store n for n in list1 if even. So this is a function. Even function is called over here by passing the value n. So here list EVP will also store the even numbers, but here the function even is called in list comprehension. So EVP also store the values for which even function returns true. Now let's print EVP. Now see the output is 2, 4, 6, 8. It is storing all the even values present in the list1. So this is how you can see a function is called within a list comprehension. Now this is a very simple code just to predict the output. You can see there is a list called B which is having some sublists 9, 6, 4, 5, 7, 7. Now X is equal to B colon 2. That means X will store the elements from index number 0 to index number 2 index number 2 will be excluded. That means index number 0 and 1. That means it will store 9, 6 and 4, 5. Now x dot append 10. So 10 is an element which will be appended with the list x. Now you can see the output of if you print x, the output is like this: 9, 6, 4, 5, and 10 is appended at the end of the list. Now you can see the code over here. B is a list which is containing some sublist, and x is equal to b within bracket colon 2. That means it will store the elements from index number 0 to index number 2 excluding. That means index number 0 and 1. Now x of 1 dot append 10. X of 1 means whatever element present at the index number 1. That means there is a sublist which is present at index number 1. With that, 10 will be appended. So you can see the output over here. The sublist which is present at index number 1, that is 4, 5. So for 10 is a new element which is appended at the end of this sublist. The output is like this. The next question is to find the errors and its reasons, considering the following code which runs correctly at times and gives error at other times. Now let's see the code, how it is. I can see there are two lists. LST1 is having some numbers and LST2 is one empty list. Now it is printing list1 originally is LST1, and there is a character which will be taken as input from the user. User has to enter 1 or 2 or 3 and predict which operation has to be performed. If the choice is equal to 1, then 100 will be appended with list1 and 100 will be appended with list2. So if you're while running the program, if you enter the choice as 1, then this operation will be done. That means 100 will be appended at the end of both the lists. And here, since the LST2 is an empty list, so simply one element 100 will be appended. Now, when you enter choice is equal to 2, it is saying LST1.index of 100. That means it is trying to access a value which is present at index number 100. But actually, that many elements are not there in LST1. So if you just write index of 100, then it will give error, as LST1 doesn't have any index number 100. Similarly, if you print LST2.index of 100, the same thing, because LST2 also does not have that many elements having index number 100. Now, if you give choice as 3, so here it is popping the elements LST1.pop. So what will happen? 88 is the last element which will be popped from LST1. But if you do that for LST2, it will give error because LST2 is one empty list. So this program will give error when you give choice 2 or 3, but it will work fine if you give choice 1. The next question is to suggest the correction for the errors in the previous question's code. You can see we can do some corrections. We can initialize LST2 with some values and so that it will not create any problem. If you pass choice 2 and if you provide index number as 100, then it may give error because that many elements are not there in the list. So you can give the index value something less, like 4 or 5, like that you can give instead of 100. In that case, it will work fine for all the three choices. The next question is to find the error in the following codes. The first code is like this: y for y in range 100, if y percent 2 equal to 0, if y percent 5 equal to 0. So this is basically only a list comprehension statement, but here if you want to put two conditions, you don't need to write if two times. You can just write if y percent is 2 equal to 0 and y percent 5 equal to 0. The second if is not recurred, so you can remove that one. That's the first error in this code. The second is the statement has to be written within square brackets. Then only it can, whatever value will be produced, that will be stored in a form of list. The next code is like this, the same thing, but here it's written in parentheses. So it's not possible. If you want to create a list, you have to write it within square brackets. Statement has to be written in square bracket instead of parenthesis. So the corrected code can be like this: list t1 is equal to y for y in range 100 if y percent is 2 equal to 0 and y percent 5 equal to 0. Now if you print list t1, it will print all these values 0, 10, 20, 30. That means the values present in the range 0 to 100, which are divisible by 2 as well as divisible by 5. The first question is to find the error in the following list comprehension. So list is like this: list is equal to good if I greater than 3, colon, else, colon, better for I in range 6. So for this type of list comprehension, you don't need to specify the colon. Can remove the colon. The corrected code is like this: list is equal to good if I greater than 3, else, better for I in range 6. Now if you print list, then you can see like this: for I greater than 3, it is printing good. For I less than 3, it is printing better, 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 like this. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now suggest the corrections for the errors in the both previous questions. We have already written the corrected codes for the previous questions. So you can just go back and check. Now here ends all the solutions of chapter 9. We have discussed all the type B questions of this chapter, linear list. If there is any doubt, then you can put in comment section, and do subscribe and stay tuned. Thank you.